Engineers have spent at least 9 years working to lessen the dangers posed by exit doors on London buses. Peggy Diamond knows those dangers only too well. She suffered head and shoulder injuries after getting trapped in the doors of a Kingston bus.
My arm was still in the bus, and the door was shut, and the driver started to go off, and there was I, sort of climbing up the side of the bus, wondering what was going to happen.
A passenger managed to get the driver to stop in her case, but these independent tests using dummies illustrate the dangers. 6 people have died after being trapped indoors since 1986, and London Buses has dealt with more than 600 insurance claims after incidents. Now the exit doors on 4,000 buses will be fitted with new sensory devices, which automatically reopen the doors if something or someone gets caught. The driver cannot pull away until the doors are completely closed. But transport campaigners want the new systems fitted to the entry doors as well.
We have had information from people who've been injured in incidents with the front doors. So I certainly think that there's a case for them to be installed on the front doors as well.
This morning, pensioners, considered the most at risk, tried out the new doors. Most gave them the thumbs up, but for Peggy, it was a case of once bitten, twice shy.
I wasn't wholly convinced by the demonstration. The only thing that pleased me was that the driver, they'd been able to override the driver's control of opening the doors or shutting the doors.
The system complies with new government regulations, and the work to fit them will cost London buses nearly £900,000. But it's hoped the benefits in making London's buses safer will be worth far more. John Dowden for Thames News.